Hi everyone, Audrey Bunny here, and we're back for more Nancy Drew Secret Scan Kill Remastered. So yeah, in the previous part, we've talked to a few students about how did Jake Rogers die. Sorry, I can't speak today. And we've also had a fake uncle who is a police officer investigating his death. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. Let's try and go back to the diner. Oh wait, actually, I have something. This says the first letters will help my plight. Okay, up, down, left, right. So I think UDLR. I'm still not sure about that. We'll get back to it later. What was that? Oh my goodness. My goodness, what was that? What was that? I'm scared right now. I heard something. Maybe it was in the gym? I don't know. I'm so scared. Wait. Let's check. Was it his locker? No. I don't think it was his locker. Wait.
How's it going?
Okay, let's ask him first.
Do you know why Jake had an empty video cassette case in his locker?
I didn't pay much attention to Jake. I'm tired of talking about that loser.
Wow, really?
Tell me about the robbery at the drug station pharmacy.
Why would I know about a robbery? All I know about is football.
Oh my goodness.
Goodbye.
You're so useless.
See ya.
Okay, let me take a picture of this one and I'll try to edit it so that we can read it. Okay, so now we're back. I've edited these clues and this one says nowhere to turn to, nowhere to hide. Let the books in the library be your answer guide. So that is clue number one. So the second one I can't really edit because you have to read it from below upwards and right to left. So it says, a symbol of kanji, worn with great pride, reflects big secret that someone must hide. So we've seen Connie Watson wearing a kanji necklace, so I think this clue is about her. So the third one says, he did what it took to make the grade, even if it meant cheating, to keep his charade. And this dude right here, he seems angry with Jake for no apparent reason for now. Let's check Hal if he has something to say. Oh.
Do you know why Jake had an empty video cassette case in his locker?
I didn't know Jake was interested in video. I avoided him whenever I could.
See ya!
See you later, Nancy.
Why would you avoid him? But the other one said you were friends with him.
Why all the questions? What's going on with you, Nancy?
Wow. Why so grumpy?
Do you know why Jake had an empty video cassette case in his locker?
No. Why are you so interested in Jake anyway? I gotta go now. Later.
Why so defensive, Biatch? Let's go back to the diner. Daryl might have some answers.
What can I do for you?
Do you know Connie Watson?
Not that well. She keeps to herself a lot. I've always thought there's something mysterious about her. Kind of the same way I feel about you.
I knew it. He was flirting all along, so let's tell him that we're seeing someone. And
thanks for the compliment, but I'm already seeing someone.
That's cool. I'm just saying, not playing.
What can you tell me about Hal Tanaka?
Hal's an exchange student who's all scholarships and study. He's very intense about becoming a doctor.
How well do you know Hulk Sanchez?
Big guy, big muscles, big dreams. A lot of football scouts have been coming over to watch him play. He must be under a lot of pressure to perform.
Didn't I hear that you found Jake's body?
Yeah, I did. The student council president gets keys to the school. We had an early morning council meeting and I found him lying there. It was the worst thing I ever experienced in my life. And I really don't want to think about it right now.
Do you know why Jake had an empty video cassette case in his locker?
Why were you in Jake's locker?
Oh, shoot. Wait. We can't tell this one because we're undercover, right? Why would you tell this guy that you're undercover? And this is impossible because it has a lock on it. So I think this is the right answer because our cover is we're a new student in Paseo del High. So let's try this one.
I'm writing an article about the murder for the school newspaper.
Oh.
That's
I have
it?
No idea. What else
oh
can
my
I do
goodness.
For you?
Never mind.
Bye.
Later.
Let's talk to Uncle. Wait. Oh man. Never mind.
Good recovery on Daryl's question about Jake's locker.
Thanks, Uncle Steve.
But reporter for school newspaper? It's not that great of a cover.
I had to think on my feet.
This one.
I found a notepad in the library that seems like a message from Jake.
Really? Tell me more.
It says, things to remember me, and seems to give clues about the answer to my fate lies in a box.
This is the best lead we've had. I think it could break the case. Follow whatever directions he gave to find this box. His journal could be in there.
Excellent work, Nancy Drew. But remember, you need to keep a low profile and be careful.
I know.
When the police looked through Jake's locker, did they take a videotape?
No. We didn't. You're thinking there's something important on that tape. Important enough that Jake hid it.
Something like that.
Good lead. Find that videotape, Nancy.
Was that a sex tape? Just kidding.
How can I get into the teacher's lounge?
Look, Nancy, maybe this assignment isn't for you. I can't be holding your hand all the time. Your job is to come to me with solutions, not problems.
Wow. Holding my hand all the time? You weren't even helping. You're just drinking your bottomless coffee over here.
Bye, Uncle Steve.
Goodbye, Nancy.
You useless uncle. Oh, I can go in here. Ooh. Wait. I want a cake. Let's go in. Oh. A ladle, huh? But... why do I need a ladle? Okay, work schedule. Maxine, Jake, Daryl. Whoa. He was working with Jake. Oh my goodness.
Looks like something was removed here.
To Maxine, Daryl, Carl, Yuli, sorry, I don't know how to pronounce this name, and Mel, from Jake Rogers, regarding closing procedure. Maxine wanted me to write a memo describing the finer points of closing the diner. Some people think there are some secrets to the process, but it couldn't be easier. After totaling out the cash register, the cashier brings the cook the receipts to the store in the potato bin. The cook also needs to check the life expiration dates on all foods and throw expired ones out. The cashier and cook get all food crumbs off the counter. The cook preps all condiments for the next day. All surfaces are washed so they're bright and shiny. Okay. Wait, that's... no, not my phone. Let's check our task list.
That's done. Haven't done that. Did that. Check. That's done. Did that. Did that. Still have to do that.
God, it's leaking. Wait. Okay. So I think we're going to need these bolt cutters. Oh, I can't use the exit. That was unsafe. Why would you leave a freaking ladle? My goodness. Don't they have preventive maintenance? Maintenance? What? Okay. Nothing here. I guess that was all. Don't mind me, Daryl. Okay, let's return to school. But first, let me save. Okay, let's go to the library. Which is not this way, but that way. Another clue, but I still don't know. Oh my goodness, this music again. I hate this. Okay, let's look for useful books that we can read. Okay, Marie Antoinette.
Okay. That medallion Connie is wearing is kanji for crane.
Okay, found it. crane. Okay. Oh, I think I know this one. But I still don't know the password for that lock. Maybe it says Jake, J-A-K-E. I still don't, oh my goodness, what's this music? Okay, let's check our task list.
Still have to do that.
Oh no, I still have to talk to her. Oh my goodness.
Did that!
The music is freaking me out. I don't know why. So now I have to get out of here and talk to Connie. Oh, finally, I hate that music. No, wait.
See you later. Goodbye, Nancy.
No, I can't find the... Wait. My goodness, I'm lost. This is kind of confusing. Wait. Where the freak is the student?
I'm not into pushy girls. Do me a favor and bother someone else.
Wow, Mr. Grumpy Pants.
Goodbye.
Bye.
I hate you too. Where the heck? Wait, I'm so freaking lost. Okay.
Nancy, I'm starting to wonder about you.
I'm starting to wonder about you too.
Your medallion has a symbol that means crane, and crane is the name of the judo school on the poster in the gym.
What a coincidence. Funny, I never noticed. I gotta go now. Later.
Can't check that off yet. Can't check that off yet. Check.
Okay, let's go back to the library. Apparently, we need more clues. Okay, what is a relic? Throughout the ages, the remains and intimate possessions of religious figures have been recovered, preserved, and venerated by their followers. Such items, known as relics, are particularly important in Catholicism. After Constantine facilitated and established the establishment of Christianity, as the predominant religion of the Roman Empire in AD 312, consecrating new churches by securing and sometimes displaying the relics of saints became standard practice. Over the centuries, as cathedrals and basilicas were built and rebuilt across Europe, the relics associated with them often dictated their political as well as spiritual importance. Relics were kept in a cavity inside the altar of a church or in a container, or more often were simply buried so they would become, literally and figuratively, part of the church's foundation. Often a relic consisted of partial remains, sometimes a single finger, oh my goodness, or a lock of hair. Sometimes it was an item a saint had habitually worn or touched, clothes, jewelry, even dishware. It was and still is not uncommon for the relics of a single saint to be in several different churches on several different continents. The bodies of some saints seemed miraculously immune to decomposition. Incorruptibles can still be seen in churches throughout Europe, lying in a state in glass their natural appearance belying the fact that they died centuries earlier. What follows is a survey of the relics that can be found in modern-day Venice. About some of them, which is unknown, about most of them, little is unknown. The history of many of them is a frustrating mishmash of fact and fancy, but none of the relics ended up where they are by accident. Someone, sometime, believed they were sacred and went to great lengths to preserve them against the unrelenting onslaught of time and human forgetfulness. Okay, there was so many for me to read. Just pause the video if you would want to read everything. No more to read. Let's try this one. Oh my goodness. Werewolves. Lycanthropy. Just pause the video if you want to read. Okay, no more to read in here. Let's try. No, we were here before. Let's go back. Okay, introduction to Ichido. Read. Just pause the video if you want to read. Oh, wait. I think this was this thing right here is posted on a bulletin board a while ago. Up, left, attack. Up, right, attack. Up, center, attack. About gemstones. Just pause the video if you want to read. guessing there are no more clues in here. Wait. Okay.
Still have to do that. Can't check that off yet.
Okay, so we're not done yet. Oh my goodness, what was that? What was that? Oh my goodness, someone took a book. Oh my goodness, wait, let me breathe my heart. Oh my goodness, that scared me. Oh my goodness. Wait, what? I can't read French. I'm not good in French. Oh my goodness. Okay, just pause the video if you want to read.
Haven't done that.
What? Really? What do I need? Wait, let's...
Bye.
Goodbye, Nancy.
You must be thinking, that Nancy girl is weird.
I'm not into pushy girls. Do me a favor and bother someone else.
Goodbye.
Later.
Sorry.
Hey, Nancy. Need something?
See you later.
Bye.
remember Connie mentioning the alarm. Okay, let's try setting an alarm that is far away from the student union, which is the gym. Wait. Okay. What?
Refreshing.
Wait. I didn't mean to do that.
Great! You broke it!
Yeah! He's so mad. Hey Nancy, something's broken.
Hey Nancy, need something?
Oh, no, I meant Connie. Sorry.
Someone set off the alarm on the soda machine again.
And it's
not Connie,
me.
The student monitor, to the rescue. Again.
Wait. You might be wondering why I'm even sending this, and I wish I had a better explanation. So many times in the hallways. Okay. I'll read it later. For now, I have to go in the lounge. I think this is the key. Go in. Oh my goodness. Can I log in here? Okay, I can. Wait a minute. Going to do here. Oh my goodness, someone's knocking. Locate missing book or order replacement for English essays through the ages. Gather donations for sophomore book sale. Update meeting information. Okay. I think I'm in trouble. We need to find a replacement for Jake Rogers for bulletin board duty. Please send me a list of candidates you recommend for this duty. Crap, I know I am in big trouble. Wait a minute. Let me look for more clues. Okay, Great Enterprises posts third lost stock tumbles by Hedda Hooper. Great Enterprises reported a $500 million second quarter loss Tuesday, but CEO and founder Eugene Gray remained optimistic about his struggling company. We anticipate increased defense spending in the next year. Our new missile guidance system, Bright Aurora, will be online in 6 months, and we foresee accelerated growth from this new system. A recent Senate hearing examining possible leaks of classified information in the Paseo del Mar company has soured many investors. Gray Enterprise stock has sunk by almost 75% in the past year. Despite these setbacks, some analysts remain positive about Gray Enterprise's future. They're the most innovative developer of military hardware, said industry analyst Brenda Bombecker. If they can weather the current storm of mismanagement and loss, they'll do very well with Bright Aurora. Mr. Gray said his company will report a strong profit this year. Any more clues in here? Oh, there's a coin. This one too. Wow, so many coins. Carry, my goodness. Wait. Okay. Where is trainer Hendrickson, Ackerman, Thompson, Anderson? out sick. I don't think... Oh yeah, I think I printed something. Yeah, this one. Paseo del Mar High School, Paseo School District. Security detail report. Okay. 5:15 p.m. Knights left on in the library. Sent email to Idru. Okay, I think this is our Aunt Eloise. 6 p.m. All outer entrance doors checked and locked. Backpack belonging to Connie Watson. Found in student union. Placed in lost and found. Several outside security lights are out. Work order submitted. Toolbox from Dylan. HVAC service left in boiler room. Left note with maintenance. 7 p.m. patrolled outside grounds on foot. Dumpsters by cafeteria were not properly secured. Several raccoons in area. I've sent several notes to kitchen staff to secure dumpsters. This needs to be addressed. 8:05 p.m. observed young man peering through school entrance doorway. He identified himself as an exchange student. I think this was Hal. At approximately 8:30 p.m., I overheard two individuals arguing outside Geyser Gym. When I approached them, two males ran down Rutherford Street. The first male was approximately 5'5", 120 pounds, red hair, 15 to 18 years old. He wore a green windbreaker and jeans. The second male was 15 to 18 years old and wore a football jersey with numbers 8 or 0 on it. Okay. 9:25 p.m. caught several students soaping teachers' lounge windows. Students admitted that they were engaged in a senior prank. I instructed the students to clean the windows and to leave campus. The students involved were Daryl Gray, Nathan Gomber, and Yvonne Wong. The students' names have been given to Principal Parton. 12:01 a.m. Heard screams from East stairwell. After calling 911, found male teenager who apparently fell from stairs. Attempted to apply first aid. See police report for further details. Oh my goodness. Can I take this? No, I can't. Okay, we're going outside. Here goes nothing.
Hello?
You better stop your nosing, or it'll get bent way out of shape.
What? I guess it was Mitch.
Dylan, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and cooling. How may I help you?
Hi, this is Nancy Drew. You called me and threatened me?
No, I didn't. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yes, you did. I saw your caller ID number.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't. I'm sorry, miss, if you're having trouble with your air conditioning. We'll send a technician to find a permanent solution.
I'm not talking about air conditioning. I'm talking about you threatening me.
I didn't threaten you.
Liar.
Look, I'm not going to play this game with you.
Can I call my boyfriend?
Hello? Is this Martha Windergrassen? Who is please calling me?
No. I'm trying to reach Ned Nickerson.
Nancy, it's Ned. I thought with you being undercover and everything,
really?
I had to take on a different persona.
Ned, I'm the one who's undercover, not you.
Okay. I guess I'll just go undercover vicariously through you, which for some odd reason feels very deja vu-ish.
It'd probably be a good idea if you didn't mention my assignment to anyone. You never know who may be related to this case, even up at Emerson.
Your secret's safe with me, along with your heart.
Oh, you're such a sweetie.
Enough lovey-dovey talk. It'll make me miss you even more. So have you found any homicidal secrets yet?
What do the dots on the lock to the maintenance room mean?
They're braille notation. The encyclopedias in the library must have information on how to decipher them.
Ciao.
Bye, Nancy.
I knew it. Were those the only numbers in my contacts? Man, Nancy. You need to talk to other people more. Let's try going to the gym.
That new girl told me you said I'm having money problems.
Oh my goodness.
So what if I did?
You're such a loser!
Don't ever use that word to refer to me!
Get out of my face, Hector!
What are you going to do? Ow! Ow, ow! Connie, stop it! You have an attitude problem.
Later.
Let's go back to Connie and see if... Oh my goodness, she's still not here. Okay, let's read this one. You might be wondering why I'm even sending this, and I wish I had a better explanation. So many times in the hallways we catch each other's eyes, and it seems like we both want to say something, but we just keep walking. You with your friends and me alone. There's so much I want to say to you. Every time I drive to or from school, it's like you're in the car with me, and we have these amazing conversations. And I'm thinking, will this ever become true? Can you ever forgive me for what I did? Can I? I want to explain, but a part of me knows that it's not safe and stupid to do. Sometimes I just can't keep it bottled inside me, and I want to scream it from the rooftop. Is this crazy? Am I? Maybe you are. My goodness.
Good job, Nancy. Better tell Connie to come fix it.
Connie isn't even here. Oh my goodness. This room again. The knocking is creeping me out. CLD2? What does that mean? Okay, senior final papers, Tanaka House.
This looks exactly like the one in Jake's locker.
Okay, passwords, athletic supply room, maintenance, note. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is to confront Hal about his essay, because we've read about this etiquette thing in Jake's locker, which was, I think, from a magazine or a book. Hal is cheating, oh my goodness. Let's go to him. This one. He plagiarized this one, so we have to confront him regarding that matter.
You plagiarized your senior essay on etiquette, and Jake knew about it.
Yes, Nancy. I'm very ashamed. My family will be extremely unhappy about this terrible mistake I have made. Somehow, Jake found out I copied that old essay. Then he blackmailed me into doing his homework for him.
Why did you copy the essay?
I had no other choice. My family won't let me stay in the United States unless I get a scholarship next year.
Oop,
I had to take extra courses to earn the scholarship. Before I realized what I had done, I was buried in work. I copied the essay because I was desperate.
What happened when Jake found out?
Jake demanded I do all his homework for the rest of the semester, or he would tell my family everything. What else could I do? My family was depending on me to succeed.
Were you desperate enough to kill him?
I was not happy about the situation, but I would never kill anyone. I value human life. Please don't tell anyone about this, I beg you. You will gain nothing if you do, and it would destroy my family if they knew what really happened. I regret what I have done. Please let me have this chance to become a doctor. I promise to make up for this mistake, even if it takes the rest of my life.
If you didn't kill Jake, do you have any idea who did?
When I delivered Jake's homework to him the other day, he mentioned being late for a meeting with Daryl Gray. It was very strange. I didn't know they were friends.
Aw, I feel bad for this guy. He was just so desperate in passing.
See ya!
Farewell, Nancy.
I guess he isn't the suspect. So...
That's done.
The task left to do is to look for Aunt Eloise's password in a safe place. Look around for Jake's messages holding the 18 steps. And look around the library for more clues. Apparently, I haven't found a lot of clues. The diner? Maybe he has something.
Hey, gorgeous. Glad you stopped by.
Ugh, stop being creepy.
What's the word on the street?
Well, your uncle isn't here if that's who you're looking for. I'm sorry for saying this, but he's kind of a Mr. Cranky Pants.
How so?
He's on edge from drinking all of our coffee, and last week he seriously freaked out on me.
What happened?
I don't know. He lost something in the diner and accused us of stealing it. He went kind of psycho.
Someone said you were caught soaping up the windows on the teacher's lounge.
Yeah, I totally got busted. It was a senior prank. I had to spend 2 days in detention.
Wasn't that the night Jake was murdered?
Yeah, I guess it was. Never really thought about that.
Is your dad the owner of Gray Enterprises?
Yep, that's him. I have an internship in the computer department at the plant. It's mega boring, but it'll look good on my college application.
Didn't I hear that Gray Enterprises went bankrupt?
So what if it did? My dad is working really hard to get the company back on track, and it doesn't help to have vultures like you gloating over it.
I'm sorry, Daryl. I didn't mean to gloat.
That's okay. I'm just a little touchy about it. What else can I do for you?
Hal Tanaka told me Jake said he had a meeting with you once, but I thought you said you hardly knew him.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe he had to talk to me about work.
Talk to you later.
Oh, before I forget, someone left this note for you. It was on the counter when I got back from break.
I have the solution to your mystery. Meet me in the basement of the maintenance room at the high school.
Bye, Nancy.
Oh my goodness. And our uncle is gone. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's take a picture of it. Okay, it's this one. So, let's try... Wait, let me check the clue again. Don't know. the password. Where's the dude that's gonna meet me up here? Emergency instructions.